council meeting, if changes needed are not isolated to one department. In addition to concerns I previously mentioned in the lost and found department, there are concerns in other areas. I hope the entire council has seen the pictures of the post-surgical complications. These pictures have been shared with some of you. Community members have told of their difficulties in scheduling appointments for spay and neuter surgeries, both in making contact and in the manner they were treated. Recently, the grant from PetSmart Charities was said to have been mutually decided to be returned. This grant was to be used to spay and neuter 800 cats a year for a total of 2 years. It was to be used in a particular zip code. The zip code had been chosen due to higher intake and lower incomes in that area. After a little over 500 cats were altered, Greenville County Animal Care felt they were unable to find a way to get cats in for surgery, so they returned the money. Over 1,000 surgeries that could have lowered intakes and would have incurred no cost to taxpayers. While citizens beg for low-cost spay and neuter, this seems to be money left on the table. Grantors tend not to want to grant funds to organizations unable to fulfill grant requirements. Concerns are not limited to Lost and Found or the clinic. Volunteers have been banned for stating the obvious. GCAC is a high-kill shelter. Some who've mentioned this on Facebook have been banned from the page. They are referred to the team at County Square. No one knows who this nameless, faceless team at County Square is. The Pet Helpline keep pets in their homes and prevent shelter surrender. Supposed to be staffed by GCAC since volunteers lack support, has been disbanded. The one session of free dog training offered to adopters, that's been discontinued because adopters were not being referred. A foster manual written by volunteers has yet to be implemented. So what do we wish for? We wish for better stewardship of our tax dollars. At a budget of almost $3 million a year and the 2014 intake of 18,515 animals, that comes to over $150 an animal. We wish for a citizens advisory committee to offer solutions. We wish for a companion animal protection ordinance to ensure procedures are followed. Upstate citizens care about their animals. Greenville and her leaders have been recognized for many forward-thinking achievements. These ideas would put another crown, or another jewel in Greenville's crown. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, ma'am. Next, Mr. Cotton.